Although the closest star from us is over 4 light-years away, there are still roughly 100 stars within the range of 20 light-years. Some of them are single, some of them are multiple. These are all sorts of stars from dim red dwarfs way smaller than Sun to big blue hot stars. Of course it's impossible to cover all of them in this video, but I will pick some most interesting ones and share with you. The closest star, which I guess you've already know, is Proxima Centauri, the closest star system to Earth at just over 4.2 light-years away. But Proxima Centauri is not alone, it is in a star system that consists of 3 stars, Alpha Centauri A, Alpha Centauri B, and Proxima Centauri. Proxima Centauri, a red dwarf, is particularly interesting as it hosts at least 2 confirmed exoplanets. By the way, it's 16,000 times dimmer than Sun, so don't want to see it with your naked eye. The Alpha Centauri B also has 1 exoplanet, a gas giant, you know, the most common type of planets in this whole universe. If you are moving slightly farther out, at 6 light-years from your home, you encounter a star that bears striking similarities to Proxima Centauri in terms of its characteristics and significance. This star, known as Barnard Star, holds a place of intrigue in the cosmic tapestry. Barnard Star is also a red dwarf. With its relatively low luminosity and proximity to our solar system, Barnard Star has become a focal point of research in the search for exoplanets. While no confirmed exoplanets have been detected orbiting this star to date, its status as a nearby red dwarf makes it an ideal candidate for such discoveries. By the way, both Proxima Centauri and Barnard Star are expected to live about 4 trillion years, which is not very long, just 400 times the lifespan of the Sun. Moving on from Barnard Star, we venture further into the cosmic expanse to encounter Wolf 359, a red dwarf star located approximately 7.9 light-years away from Earth. Despite its diminutive size and low luminosity, Wolf 359 holds a place of significance in both astronomical research and popular culture. In the realm of science fiction, Wolf 359 gained fame as the site of a pivotal battle in the Star Trek series. However, in the realm of science, Wolf 359 is renowned for its high proper motion. A high rate of proper motion can indicate that the star is located nearby, as closer stars can achieve the same rate of angular change with a lower relative speed. This star is also basically the same as the previous 2 red dwarfs, but its mass is the smallest among the 3 red dwarfs. Its surface temperature is only 2,500 degrees Celsius. Continuing, we arrive at Sirius, the brightest star in the night sky and one of the most recognizable celestial objects visible from Earth. Located just 8.6 light-years away, Sirius has been observed and revered since ancient times, earning it a place of prominence in cultures around the world. Sirius is part of a binary star system, with Sirius A being the primary component and Sirius B, a white dwarf companion, orbiting around it. Why Sirius B is a white dwarf while Sirius A is still a normal star? That's because Sirius B was more massive, but massive equals short-lived. As a result, it passed the red giant stage in the age of dinosaurs. Anyway, with its dazzling brightness and close proximity to our solar system, Sirius A alone is still enough to be the brightest star in the night sky with no one challenging, serving as a beacon of light in the vast darkness of space. Stepping further, you will find more and more red dwarf stars. These are basically, once you've seen one, you've seen them all. Until you find Ran, or Epsilon Eridani. Located approximately 10.5 light-years away from Earth, Epsilon Eridani is a young star surrounded by a disk of debris, hinting at the possibility of planets forming in its vicinity. This star has garnered attention from astronomers due to its relatively close proximity and potential for hosting planetary systems. It is smaller than Sun but not a red dwarf, a bit larger than that, an orange dwarf. Surface temperature at 4,800 degrees Celsius, not too cold compared to red dwarfs, and too hot compared to you. Then you pass some more red dwarfs. And you would stop at a star blooming white light. Procyon. The Canis Minor, which is just a line, but Procyon is the main star of that line. At a distance of approximately 11.4 light-years, Procyon shines brightly as one of the nearest stars to Earth. This binary star system consists of a main sequence star, Procyon A, a white dwarf companion, Procyon B, which is ominously similar to Sirius. Its close proximity and visibility from our planet have made it a subject of study for astronomers seeking to better understand stellar evolution and dynamics. If you were traveling in another direction, then at the same distance, you would meet 61 Cygni. a binary orange dwarf system and is the first star system to have measured distance. Sadly, we didn't find any exoplanets here. At 11.6 light years, DX Cancri, also known as Gliese 1111, is a red dwarf star. It is a bit different as it's a variable star, meaning that it's changing brightness under a certain pattern. It is a flare star that has random, intermittent increases in brightness by up to a factor of 5. Alright, the next one. Situated roughly 11.9 light years away, Epsilon Indi is a multiple star system comprising one orange dwarf and two brown dwarfs about 10% the mass of the main star. The main star owns one gas giant planet. This system has drawn interest from astronomers due to its relative proximity and has been the subject of various studies aimed at the formation of gas giants and brown dwarfs. And at the same distance, different direction, there is a way more interesting star there. Tau Ceti. Finally, there is a cousin of Sun and Alpha Centauri A. I mean, its similarity to the Sun in terms of temperature and luminosity. Tau Ceti has been the focus of numerous studies aimed at searching for potentially habitable exoplanets within its vicinity. While no confirmed exoplanets have been detected around Tau Ceti to date, there are 8 possible exoplanets there. Yes, 8 planets, reminds you what? 7 of them are super-Earths. Ironically, none of the planets is in the habitable zone. But ongoing research continues to investigate this intriguing star system. Ahem, yeah. Captian Star is a red dwarf star located roughly 12.8 light years away from Earth. It is a red dwarf but way bigger than Proxima and Barnard stuff. So big that its lifespan shrinks to just less than 200 billion years. It is one of the oldest known stars in the Milky Way galaxy, being about 7 billion years older than Sun, and has captured the interest of astronomers due to its unusual movement and potential for hosting exoplanets. The star orbits the Milky Way backwards. Why? Maybe it's because this star, along with some other stars, once have been members of a globular cluster that is thought to be the remnant of a dwarf galaxy that merged with the Milky Way. Recent studies have revealed the presence of at least 2 exoplanets orbiting Captian Star, making it an object of interest in the search for potentially habitable worlds. Going further out, Van Mayenen Star is a white dwarf located approximately 14.1 light years away, while Gliese 440 is also a white dwarf star situated about 15.9 light years away. Both stars are old. As a white dwarf, Van Mayenen Star has cooled down to just 6,000 degrees Celsius. Gliese 440 is younger, at 8,000 degrees. Based on their mass, it's very likely that these stars were once sun-like stars. Now they're dead. Finally, at 15 to 20 light years, there is only one important star. Altair. Altair is a bright white star located approximately 16.7 light years away from Earth. It is one of the 3 stars that make up the prominent summer triangle asterism and holds significance in both scientific and cultural contexts. The star itself is also very interesting. For instance, Altair's rapid rotation shapes it like an egg. And it is a very young star, just over 100 million years old. Also, the brightness of Altair fluctuates slightly, making it a variable star. You see, every star in this video is unique, isn't it?
Once you've seen one.
From the faint glow of red dwarfs to the dazzling brilliance of blue giants, each star possesses its own set of characteristics and mysteries waiting to be unraveled. Some stars host planetary systems teeming with potential for life, while others offer insights into the turbulent processes of stellar evolution. Whether they are solitary beacons in the cosmic expanse or part of intricate binary systems, these stars captivate our imagination and inspire a sense of wonder at the vastness and complexity of the universe. So next time you are looking at a star, keep in mind that behind it is a fascinating story that has been going on for hundreds of millions of years.
And have a good day.